The government completed its case against Zacarias Moussaoui on Wednesday with its single most chilling piece of evidence, a tape from the cockpit of United Flight 93 that recorded the terrorists overwhelming the pilots on September 11, 2001, slashing their throats and praising Allah before crashing the jet into a Pennsylvania field. The 32-minute recording begins at 9:31 a.m. with terrorists forcing the two pilots at knife point to give up control of the aircraft. Apparently dragged outside the cockpit onto the flight deck, the pilots can be heard begging for their lives. "I don't want to die," one shouts. Within 2 minutes, the pilot's dead or dying. One of the hijackers proclaims in Arabic, "Everything is fine. I finished." For the next 20 minutes, the plane, originally headed west to San Francisco, turns east on a flight path toward Washington and the U.S. Capitol building. 3 minutes after 10 a.m., passengers seem to be breaking through the cockpit door, fighting with the hijackers in a futile effort to take back the throttle. "Go, go," they encourage one another. "Move, move." But the terrorists have flipped the plane upside down. They spin it downward. "Shall we finish it off?" a hijacker asks in Arabic. In its final plunge, the hijackers shout over and over in Arabic, "Allah is the greatest. Allah is the greatest." The tape ends. The alternately frantic, pleading, and brutal voices from Flight 93, heard by the public for the first time, made for an emotionally draining morning of testimony as prosecutors sought the death penalty for Moussaoui, an Al-Qaeda member who has pleaded guilty to terrorism charges. Hamilton Peterson, whose father and stepmother died on the plane, said hearing an enhanced tape earlier had convinced him passengers killed a hijacker guarding the cockpit. "It is an example of ordinary citizens on a moment's notice stepping up and protecting the U.S. Capitol from a terrorist attack," he said outside the courthouse afterward. Captured September 2011 mastermind Khalid Sheikh Mohammed has said the Capitol was the plane's target. As the cockpit recorder played, the government also displayed a computer image on television monitors throughout the courtroom, synchronized with events on the tape. The images included the plane's altitude measurements and flight path and a small, simulated image of the plane itself, sometimes rocking back and forth when the terrorists jerked on the controls to keep the passengers at bay. The United Airlines flight had taken off about 50 minutes earlier from Newark, New Jersey. On board were the two pilots, 33 passengers, and 5 flight attendants. Sitting among them were the man soon to be piloting the jet, identified as the Hijacker, and 3 so-called muscle hijackers. By the time they breached the cockpit at about 9:31 a.m., 2 other hijacked planes already had slammed into the World Trade Center in New York. The Pentagon was about to be hit by a 3rd plane. In the air above eastern Ohio, the struggle was just beginning. The first word of trouble was captured by 2 ground control recordings that were played for jurors on Tuesday. The pilots screamed "Mayday" 4 times, then yelled "Get out of here! Get out of here!" The cockpit voice recorder picked up from there at 9 hours 31 minutes 57 seconds REM, with the plane apparently under the control of JARA. Speaking to passengers and flight attendants over the plane's intercom system, he tells them in broken English to remain calm. "Ladies and gentlemen," Jarrah says, "hear the captain, please sit down, keep remaining seating. We have a bomb on board. So sit." He is followed by shouts apparently aimed at the pilots as the 3 muscle hijackers force them onto the floor of the flight deck just outside the cockpit. "20 move. Shut up. Come on, come. Sit, sit, sit down." Later, noise is heard from the flight deck. It is all in English, a mixture of hijackers and the 2 United pilots. "No," pleads a pilot. "No, no, 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 go ahead. Lie down. Lie down. Down, down, down. Please, 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 don't hurt me. Oh God." A pilot is later heard, "I don't want to die." And from the pilot again, or the other pilot, "I don't want to die. I don't want to die." The pilots are not heard from again. Many of the passengers and attendants start calling emergency numbers and loved ones, saying the pilot's throats have been cut, that they are dead or gravely wounded on the floor up front. Some say the hijackers are armed with small knives. They say one professes to have a bomb strapped around his waist. The cockpit voice recorder picks up again. It is now 9 hours 39 minutes 11 seconds, at least 8 minutes into the hijacking. Ah says a man, apparently Jara, speaking in English to the passengers. Here is the captain. I would like to tell you all to remain seated. We have a bomb aboard, and we are going back to the airport, and we have our demands. So, please remain quiet. It appears the hijackers are growing confused and worried about the passengers. In the name of Allah, shouts one, I bear witness that there is no other God but Allah. They consider moving all three of the muscle hijackers into the cockpit with Jarrah to keep it secure from the passengers. Apparently referring to the axe routinely stored in cockpits, they debate using an axe. So everyone will be scared. Outside the cockpit door, someone says in Arabic, is there something? A fight. Yeah, then, let us go guys. Allah's greatest. Allah's greatest. Oh guys, Allah's greatest. About 20 minutes after the plane is commandeered, the passengers are attacking. There are sounds of shoving and fighting. Terrorists are shouting for the passengers to stay back. They cry, oh Allah, oh Allah, oh the most gracious. A band of passengers is nearing. A muscle hijacker shouts back to Jarrah, they want to get in there. Hold, hold from the inside. Hold from the inside. Hold. They are fighting at the cockpit door. The passengers are almost there, the voice is louder. Let us get them, someone screams. In the cockpit, Jarrah and another hijacker debate in Arabic whether it is time to simply ditch the plane. Shall we finish it off? No, not yet. When they all come, we finish it off. Now the passengers seem almost upon them. A passenger yells in the cockpit. If we do end, we'll die. At 10 hours 0 minutes 42 seconds, Jarrah begins to roll the plane to knock the passengers off balance. 4 times they shout in Arabic, apparently to subdue the passengers, cut off the oxygen. The passengers are almost there, shouting go, go, move, move. One hijacker tells another, down, down. Pull it down, pull it down. It appears he means the throttle to crash the plane. 5 shouts rise up in Arabic, Allah is the greatest. In English, someone cries, no. But his cry is drowned by 4 more shouts, louder now, Allah is the greatest. At 10 hours 3 minutes 9 seconds, the tape went dead. The courtroom fell silent and jurors sat back in their seats. A few more government witnesses testified, and then the prosecution rested its case. The last item of evidence was a giant poster board carrying tiny photos of each of the 2,972 killed that day. The defense is to begin its case today and hopes to convince jurors that Moussaoui is mentally ill and should not be executed. Moussaoui is expected to testify a second time.
Awkward. Are you watching the tag 5-1 out there?
I guess
right turn back. We'll just put them in back to direct St. Louis and they can put in whatever they want just so we can turn them back.
Lorraine. 75,
yeah, then.
Get out of here! Get out of here! This is here. They got the piece of dark. Keep it ready to see. We have a bomb aboard. So it's soon.
following portion of day begins at 09:17 hours, 22 seconds, taken from position 8. Dictaphone prologue originally recorded on cassette 571, the item 4, day 2, on September 11, 2001.
Holy Mary, Mother of God.
8695, good morning, have a good day.
Hi, what's your number again, please?
8695.
I'm on the 83rd floor. 86
what?
I'm on the 83rd floor.
86 what? 8695. 8695? She had the World Trade Center. Someone having difficulty breathing on the 83rd floor. Okay, ma'am, how you doing?
Are they going to be able to get somebody up here?
Well, of course, ma'am. We're coming up for you.
Well, there's no one here yet, and the floor is completely engulfed. We're on the floor, and we can't breathe.
Okay.
And it's very, very, very hot.
Are the lights still on?
The lights are on, but it's very hot.
Ma'am, take
very care. Hot. We're all the way on the other side of Liberty, and it's very, very hot.
Any lights? Because you can turn the lights off?
No, the lights are off.
Okay, good. Now, everybody stay calm. You're doing a good job.
Please.
Ma'am, listen. Damn it. Everybody's coming. Everybody knows. Everybody knows what happened, okay?
Here.
But no, they have to take time to come up here. You know that. Got to be very careful.
It's very hot.
I understand. Got to be very, very careful how they approach you, okay? All right? So when they come upstairs, it won't be worse than it is. Now, you stay calm. So how many people where you're at right now?
There's like 5 people here with me.
All up from the 83rd floor?
83rd floor.
With 5 people, 5 patients. Everybody's having trouble breathing?
Everybody's having trouble breathing. Some people are worse.
And some people are unconscious. Everybody's awake?
So far, yes. But it's
listen. Everybody's awake?
Yes, so far.
Conscious. And it's very hot there, but no fire, right?
I can't see because it's too high.
Very hot. No fire for now. And no smoke, right? No smoke, right?
Of course there's smoke.
Ma'am, you have to stay calm.
There is smoke. I can't breathe.
Okay, you stay calm with me, okay? I understand.
I think there is fire because it's very hot.
Okay.
It's very hot everywhere on the floor.
Okay. I know you don't see it, and I know, but I'm documenting what you say, okay? And it's very hot. We see no fire, but you see smoke, right?
It's very hot. I don't see any air anymore.
Okay.
All I see is smoke.
Okay, dear, I'm so sorry. Hold on one. Stay calm with me. Stay calm.
Please. Listen.
The call is in. I'm documented. I'm going to let those... Hold on one second, please.
I'm going to die, aren't I?
No.
I'm going to die.
Ma'am, say your prayers. And we're not
going to...
We're going to think positive because you got to help each other get off the floor.
Stay calm.
You're doing a good job, ma'am. You're doing a good job.
I'm burning up.
The floor is hot and everything is hot. All their deaths is when you go up high, you get too close away from the smoke. Okay, I know you know. Hold on a second.
83rd floor, 3 people trapped. Very hot on the 83rd floor. 3 people trapped. Having trouble breathing. It's very hot.
Wait, we hear voices. Help!
That's what I'm doing. I'm just letting you know. Hello, ma'am?
Help!
Stay calm. Ma'am?
Help!
Stay calm. Just don't move.
Oh, my God.
They coming through with you now?
Find out if there's anybody here on the 83rd floor.
Ma'am, don't worry. You stay on the phone with me, and
find out if there's anyone on the 83rd floor? Because
ma'am, I already... Listen.
Somebody.
Excuse me. I already notified this lieutenant, okay? 8-0, I notified the city.
8-0?
Yes, Lieutenant 8-0. I already notified the lieutenant that there's 5 people on the 4th floor, right? Very hot and smoky, so they will overlook you, okay, dear?
Can you?
I already did that.
Stay on the line with me, please.
Yes, ma'am. I am going to stay with you.
I'm dying.
Listen.
They're here?
Are they inside with you yet, dear?
No.
Okay, stay calm till they get inside.
Find out where they are.
Ma'am, stay calm till they get inside.
Karen.
EMS, what's the job number you have?
I have 727.
727?
Yes. Hey. They have water coolers in there for you, ma'am? On that floor? Well, they said the explosion was on the 86th floor.
This is a different building.
Oh, a different building.
Both buildings.
Now, what? Ma'am, stay calm. What address is this building? They should have routed me that call. You routed it
on the... EMS is down.
Okay, I'll put that in. Ma'am, stay calm. I'm doing it now. Two World Trade Center?
Yep, on the 83rd floor.
And the phone number is 212?
Uh-uh. 466-6331.
Ma'am, just stay calm for me, okay? I think so, ma'am. Ma'am, listen to me. Listen to me, ma'am. You're not dying. Bad situation. You're in a bad situation, ma'am. Hold on. Hold on a second. AC, hold on, ma'am. Do not have AC, talk to her.
Hello, ma'am, calm down, okay? Just take a deep breath. Ma'am, just take a deep breath. Police is MS on their way. Calm down, okay? On their way. Hey, there's something. This is them telling me they're on their way. Okay, listen to me. Ma'am, do you fire? Now look, you just feel heat though, right?
Ma'am, there's no, listen to me.
Ma'am.
Okay, and it's feeling, not on the, it's the heat on the floor. Oh my God, listen ma'am. Listen to me, stay calm. Okay, listen, no, don't be sorry. You're in a bad situation. Just gotta say our prayers and think of ways. When they check, you have exes, they have ways to tell you to get out of there. They have exes in there, ma'am.
What number do you
have? Ma'am, stay calm. Ma'am.
What number
do they have? Ma'am. I'll write it down. 1 second. What's her name? Mm-hmm. Hold on 1 second, ma'am. Please hold. Don't hang up the phone. ACD, talk to her. Talk to her. ACD.
Yes, I'm here.
Talk to the patient for me.
Okay, ma'am, you all right? I'm doing a little on her. Yes.
Hello? Okay. Her name is Evelyn what, ma'am?
A-L-G-E-R-T-E-T. And the phone number is
218-0-1. Yes, ma'am. Okay. What's your name, ma'am? Melissa. How you spell it? Mm-hmm. Oh, I. Okay, and your mother is Evelyn. How you spell her last name? A-L. We are trying, ma'am. No matter what, we're trying with the court. Yes, ma'am.
Her number is her last name is A-L-D-E-R-E-T.
Yes, you can breathe, ma'am. You can breathe. Stay calm. Breathe slowly. Talk slowly. Think of something different from where you're at, okay? Hold on, listen to me. Stay calm. Think positive. What's everybody else doing, ma'am? They just... Okay. We couldn't put her on this three-way anyway. We don't have a three-way system for that, ma'am. But, I would, No, ma'am, don't go. Anybody else want to leave their name? I'll take their names. Is anybody else on telephones, too? Hello, ma'am. Melissa, do not give up, please. Please don't give up, Melissa. Please do not give up. Oh, my God. Melissa. Melissa, I'll call your mother in a second. Let me call your mother for you and tell her to hold on. There's no way. Oh, Melissa. No doors. Oh, my God. I'm on this call. Melissa, who are you talking to? Melissa, who are you talking to, big? Melissa, don't hang up the phone. Melissa, don't hang up the phone. Just stay on the phone, okay? Gotta keep communicating. Don't hang up the phone. They blew the doors open, so the doors are open to that floor, correct? Melissa. 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 Melissa, can you hear me? Melissa. 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 They said they blew the doors off.
Why he think he's the door closed?
He doesn't know. He's not there.
Oh, okay.
So, who's that? You talk to the fire department? Ma'am? Melissa?
Hello?
Melissa?
The phone is still open.
Melissa? 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 Melissa. 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 Okay, AC, you still there? Her phone. 8218.
Her mother's?
Yes.
1801.
Okay, well, make sure. Oh, 100, you mean, right?
Oh, 100.
Okay, 212-818-01. Oh, my. Melissa, Melissa. Oh, 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 my God. Melissa, is that the fire department talking to you all? Melissa. Melissa. Melissa, is this the South Tower building? Melissa. 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 Oh, my God. Melissa. Yeah. Melissa. 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 Can you hear me, dear? Melissa? It's going to be all right. Just keep saying your prayers. It's going to be all right. Melissa. 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 Melissa, can you hear me, dear? I'm gonna be fine. Just keep speaking fine. Oh my God. Melissa? Melissa, can you hear me? Can anyone hear me? Melissa? Melissa, can you hear me? Melissa, it's going to be all right. Breathe slow, stay close to the floor. Okay, Melissa? It's going to be all right. Just stay close to the floor. Breathe slowly. It's going to be okay. Oh, my God. Melissa. 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 ACD, you still there, dear?
Yes, I'm still here.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
Hold on, baby. Melissa? Nobody's talking.
Nobody, I hear a guy in the background.
That is, I think that's the fire department trying to get their attention. Because he was giving the instructions, remember?
Yes.
And nobody's answering. Everybody's asleep, I guess, or down on the floor, unconscious. So I hope they're okay. So much smoke. Till they blew the doors off.
Second building.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm.
I'm out of this. Get it?
No routes are coming over, AZ. I think it has something to do with that.
Yeah.
Melissa, it's going to be all right. You'll be able to call your mom when you get out. Come and see you. How you doing. Talk to her yourself. Hey, Melissa. Oh, my God. Melissa, please. You're going to be all right. You're going to be fine. You'll be able to talk to your mother yourself. But you got to think positive. You got to stay calm. Okay, you'll be able to talk to your mother yourself, all right? Melissa? You're going to be fine. They're going to come get you. Oh, my God. Melissa? You're going to be fine. Everybody's going to be fine. You'll come and tell your mother yourself. What a good mom she is. I got the phone number. Don't worry about that. You're going to be all right. Going to be all right. Keep praying. Okay? Okay, they'll be in there soon. Takes a while to get up those stairs. They'll be there. Going to be fine. Going to be fine. Gonna be fine. Gonna be fine. Melissa, you can hear me. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. Gonna be fine. Be fine. Melissa, keep on breathing. Keep on breathing. Possible. They sound like they might be unconscious. They think.
Okay.
Yeah. They just keep talking, saying positive things. Okay, Melissa, it's going to be fine. All right? It's going to be fine. It's gonna be fine. Oh my gosh. Hey, Melissa, stay with us, please. Everything's going to be fine. I know you're in a bad situation, but it's going to be fine. As soon as it's over with, call your mother yourself, okay? They'll come. Should have everybody move from downtown here.
Yeah, they should, because it's going to get a whole lot worse.
It's crowded. Okay, don't worry, Melissa, because they need to clear the traffic.
Yeah.
Hello, Melissa?
Yeah, hold on a minute. Hold on.
I'm going to stay on here. Don't hang up there.
Hey, down here on the 83rd floor, there was five people trapped, right? I'm on from all animal connections, so you know, everybody there. But now, the girl was talking, now all of a sudden, everybody's unconscious now.
Everybody's snoring.
Plus, for her mother, and left her laugh, which was all O Anna. It's dead. Now,
all
we hear is.
No, it's not dead.
You put in a new job? Because everything was supposed to go under
78.
Stay on the line.
ACD, what's your ACD number again?
Oh, 2252.
2252 is not dead. They're snoring.
Are they sleep?
They're snoring. They sound like, you know, you get unconscious real deep sleep because you snore.
Okay.
So they're snoring. I don't know if she's unconscious or just out of breath, but it sounds like they're unconscious and snoring. That's why I keep talking to them.
Oh, okay.
Are they empty? Tomorrow?
Yes.
The line is dead now. They hung up.
Oh, my Lord.
The lot is out there. No. No. This is... No. No. Oh, the line is there. They cut the line is off now.
Okay, thank you, Anthony.
All right.
Okay.
The preceding portion of tape concludes at 09:41 hours, 10 seconds.
Stand by for message number 117. Elusive is seen on September 11, 2001. Find 911 operator 1007, on position number CT16 to number Y34, and reference to screen channel number T03081. This call was recorded on master tape number 10049, channel number 16. The message commences at 0900 hours, 05 minutes, and 17 seconds.
Police operator 1007, how can I help? Alright, what floor are you on? Alright, ma'am, we're going to be getting systems there. They are there, they're trying to get to you, okay? We're on the 103rd floor. I can't tell you, I don't know exactly right now, ma'am. Okay, is anyone hurt on that floor? Alright, ma'am, we're on system. I don't know, ma'am. Really don't know. Just stay where you at. We have. I understand. Breaking the windows. I understand, ma'am. I'm so sorry that you have to go through this. But be assured we are trying our best to get you all out. What's the phone number you're calling for? We have firemen, emergency service. We have everyone there. Everyone there. They're going to get y'all out as soon as they can.
Message number 117 concludes at 0900 hours, 07 minutes, and 43 seconds.
Message number 7, it's a 911 call originally received on September 11, 2001, by non-operator 1844, opposition CP13, terminal J13, and recorded on instant playback module 3 from channel 28. The message is committed at 08 hours, 56 minutes, and 09 seconds.
Police operator 1844, what's your emergency? Okay, what floor you on, ma'am? Okay, the one. Okay, it's smoky and okay, can you hold on a second? Okay, ma'am, can you just you're saying there's a lot of chaos going on here. It's room. Of course. Hold on one second. Hold on just one second, okay? Okay, hold on. Excuse me. If they're saying that there's a fire on a specific floor, what? A smoke, 103.
103?
Right, floor 103. Hello, ma'am? Hello, ma'am. Okay, you're saying it's floor 103. What's the room? Floor 103, what? Room. You don't know what room you're in? Okay, ma'am. Fire department. Okay, ma'am. This is on the 103 floor. Okay, and you said you have approximately 30 people? Approximately 30 people? Okay. Is anyone injured at this time? Okay. One second, I'm going to try to connect you to the fire department.
461. Okay, ma'am. Okay, can you get out? On the 103rd floor. Northwest side. Okay, we're gonna get to, is there a room number or anything? What? Ma'am, just listen to me. 103rd floor, northwest. Correct? Give me a phone number you're at. Alright, ma'am, I'm gonna get somebody up there to you. 461. Ma'am, if you have to, you break a window. If you have to. If you don't break it.
Okay.
I'm going to get somebody there to get you, okay? Don't break anything. Don't do anything unless they tell you. Ma'am, I'm going to try and get somebody as fast as I can. I need to get off the phone to do that. I am not going to be able to call you back. We're very busy right now. Everybody's calling, ma'am. All right?
Okay, that's... And it's floor 103. Okay, thank you, ma'am. Okay, bye-bye.
This is number 7, concludes at 08 hours, 59 minutes, and 56 seconds.